الرحمن الرحيم. الله لا إله إلا هو. الله اسم مبتدأ. We have seen Allah as Alif Lam is part of the noun. And we say Ya Allah, Hamza is not omitted in this construction only. In other constructions, it is omitted. Then La ilaha illa huwa, that is khabar, La ilaha illa huwa. Ilah has no alif. It's written without alif because it was omitted in the Uthmanic codex. It is now, many of the words, hadha for example, ilah, ar-Rahman, all these are written without alif as it is in the Uthmanic codex. La ilaha illa huwa. La ilaha, la is la nafi al-jins. And khabar is mahzuf, la ilaha yastahiqqu al-ibadata. It's mentioned here. Yastahiqqu deserves. No god, god is small g, no god deserves worship except Allah. Because we have lots of gods in the world. Gods in the sense those who claim to be God. Those who claim to be God. La ilaha illa huwa. Huwa is badal from the dhamir in yastahiqu. La ilaha yastahiqu al-ibadata. La ilaha yastahiqu al-ibadata illa huwa. So there is dhamir mustatir here, la yastahiqu, which goes back to ilah. La ilaha yastahiqu al-ibadata illa huwa. Al-hayyul qayyum. The verb is hayya yahya. Hayya. Hayya. Min bab. Which bab? Sami'a. Hayya. But also use hayya with idgham. This is easier to pronounce hayya. But the original form is hayya, like sami'a hayya. Mudara' is yahya. This name Yahya literally means he lives. Yahya. There's an ayah mentioned here. La yamutu fiha wa la yahya. La yamutu fiha. In the fire. La yamutu fiha. He does not die. Wa la yahya. Nor does he live. La yamutu fiha wa la yahya. So hayya, I, ana, la, ahya al-mudari, maadi, 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 hayya, hayitu, hayitu, hayitu. Hayitu. Lan ansa. I've given the sentence here. Lan ansa musa'adataka ma hayitu. What does it mean? Lan ansa musa'adataka ma hayitu. I'll never forget your favor. as long as I live. Ma hayitu. This ma is what is it called? Ma hayitu. Ma, what is it? What is it called? Masdariya warfiya. Masdariya warfiya. That means ma muddata hayati. Muddata hayati. I will not forget your favor for the period of my life. So ma, we have seen that, no? In the book 3, ma. Zarfiyya, masdariyya, zarfiyya. Ma hayitu, as long as I am alive. Ma hayitu. Al-hayyu is ism al-fa'il, al-hayyu, the living. The living. We don't have from hayya, hayyun. The living. Huwa hayyun. Hayyun am mayyitun. Ahayyun huwa am mayyitun. Is it alive or dead? Ahayyun huwa am mayyitun. Hayyun. Huwa hayyun yurzaq. This is how we said. Is he, so and so is alive? Yes. Huwa hayyun yurzaq. That he is provided with provision by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is alive. That huwa hayyun yurzaqu. Yurzaqu. That means he is alive. Hayyun yurzaq. Hayyun plural is? Ahya'un. Ahya'un. In the Quran we have done Ahya'un. Bal Ahya'un in the Rabbihim yurzaqun. Ahya'un. Hayyun, ahya'un, living. Nowadays, we have taken from English. In English, we say live broadcast, live. Live means direct, not recorded. So we say al-bath al-hay, al-bath al-hay. That is live broadcast, al-hay. This is a translation of the English. Allah la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum. Qayyum is fay'ul. On the measure of, pattern of, fay'ul. Fay'ul. Qayyum. The ya is extra. Wow. Qayyum fa'ul. It should have been qayyum, but the waw has been assimilated to ya. It has been qayyum. Qama yaqumu. Qama yaqumu, in the sense to manage, to look after. Qama bil amri. Qama bil amri. That is to look after, to manage. So Qayyum is he who looks after, the manages the affairs of the whole universe. Qayyum. We also have another noun, Qayyimun. Qayyimun. In the same sense, but this is not, Qayyum is used only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But you can use qayyim for human beings. Qayyimun, in the sense of a manager. I've written here, there's a famous Arabic Islamic scholar, Muhammad ibn Abi Bakr, but he is famous by this title, Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyyah. Ibn al-Qayyim, have you heard? Yeah. Ibn al-Qayyim, his famous book, Zadul Ma'ad. Zadul Ma'ad. So, his title is Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyyati. And for short, we say Ibn al-Qayyim. Ibn al-Qayyim. Okay. What does it mean? Ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawziyya. Jawziyya is the name of a school in Damascus. Ancient times. Al-Jawziyya. Qayyum al-Jawziyya, the manager of the Jawziyya school. The manager of the Jawziyya school. So this great author was the son of the manager of this school. So that has stuck to his name, say Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyya, the son of the manager, the caretaker of the Jawziyya school. But the whole thing is used only in books, but ordinarily you say Ibn al-Qayyim. Ibn al-Qayyim says, Qala Ibn al-Qayyim, the son of the manager, the caretaker said. So his name was Muhammad Ibn Abi Bakr, but known by his title Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyya. Is that clear? So the word Qayyim for a manager, caretaker is used. It can be used for human beings, but Al-Qayyum is used only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It means one who manages the affairs of the whole universe. Sustainer, I have translated as sustainer. Al-Hayyul Qayyum, Al-Hayy, the living one. Allah, there is no God deserving worship except He, the living and the sustainer, the living one and the sustainer. لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم. سنة, we have seen there are verbs which start with a waw. First article is waw. In masdar, this waw either is retained or is omitted. وصف يصف. We have two masdar, wasf and also sifatun, description. Wasafa, he described. Yasifu, wasfun and sifatun. Wazana yazinu, to weigh. Waznun and zinatun. Zinatun also means weighing. Wazana. Wasala yasilu, to arrive. Waslun and silatun. Wasiqa yasiqu, to trust. Wufuqun, and without waw, fiqatun. So, the mu'tallul fa, mu'tallul fa. There is another name for mu'tallul fa. What is it? Al-mithal. A verb with a waw as the first radical. Wazana, wajada. So it's called Al-Mithal, Al-Mithalul Wawi, Al-Mithalul Wawi. Where is it? You can also have Ya'i, Ya'isa, to be hopeless, to lose hope. Ya'isa, Ya'asu, that is Mithal Ya'i. Al-Mithalul Wawi, where the first radical is a waw, like Wazana, Wajada, Wasala, Waqa'a. So, wasina yawsanu, wasina yawsanu. You remember in al-mithal, the waw is omitted. Wazana yazinu, wazana yazinu. Waw is, actually it was yawzinu, but waw is. But there are a few verbs where the waw is retained. One of them is wasina yawsanu. Wasina yawsanu. This is min bab fa'ila. Wazina, wazana yazinu. That is bab daraba yadribu. Wajada yajidu. Wasala yasilu. But this is wasina yawsanu. There is another verb, wajila. Yawjalu. To be afraid. It's in the Quran, we will see that. Wajilat qulubuhum. Wajilat qulubuhum. Their hearts are afraid. Wajila. Wasina yawsanu. Wasina yawsanu is to be drowsy. To be drowsy. There is a beginning of sleep. Drowsy, feeling drowsy. So masdar from wasina yawsanu, by dropping the waw, will be sinatun. Sinatun. Okay, in sanatun, sanatun, which radical has been lost? Sanatun. Where is it? Sanatun. Yes, the waw, where is it? What is the position of waw? First radical, second, third? Huh? Sanatun. Third radical. Sanawatun, plural. So, seen, noon, waw. Seen, noon, waw. Sanatun. The third radical has been lost there, sanatun. But in sinatun, which radical has been lost? First radical. Because it is wasina, yausanu. The first radical has been lost. Sanatun, the third radical has been lost. And the ta is the compensation. Arabic always, you know, compensates. If it takes away anything, it compensates. Yes, ta marbuta is very freely given. So ta marbuta is a compensation for the loss of the radical. So wasina yawsanu sinatun. Sinatun is drowsiness. La ta'khudhu sina ta'khudhu. Who is maf'ul bihi? La ta'khudhu. Where is the fa'il? Sinatun. La ta'khudhu sinatun. Slumber does not overtake him. Drowsiness does not overtake him. La ta'khudhu sinatun. Wala naumun. Nor sleep. Sleep is the second stage, the last stage. And sinatun is the first stage where you just feel drowsy, you feel as if you're going to sleep. لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم. Now let us, second page, we see the verbs. Yes, here, page 29 we have. Wazana is, you know, wazanan, wazinatan. Page 29, at the end of the bottom of the page. Wa'ada ya'idu. What is wa'ada? Promise. Wa'ada ya'idu wa'dan with waw. Wa'idatan without waw. This waw here is not waw. This waw al-atf. I know. Wa'dan, wa'idatan. Wa'ada ya'idu. What does wa'adha mean? To preach, to admonish, to... Wa'adha ya'idhu. Wa'adhan wa'idhatan. Idhatun. Idhatun is a lesson, admonition, lecture containing... yes, admonition to... Wasafa yasifu wasfan wasifatan. Wafiqa yathiqu, to trust. Wuthuqan, this is from on the pattern of fu'ul, like jalasa yajlisu julusan. Wathiqatan, that we have done. Wasina yawsanu wasanan. It's not wasanan, wasanan. Sin has got a fatha, please remember. Wasanan, wasinatan. Washa yashi washyan washiyatan. Washa yashi has got two meanings. One One of the two meanings is to slander, to report against somebody. Vasha yeshi, vishayatan. Masdar is vishayatan. Vishayatan. Vishayatan is to carry tales. If you go and tell his senior, this man is not doing his work. I always see him sleeping in his office. So that is vishaya, vasha yeshi, to report against somebody with a intention of harming him. It's vishaya. So this is vishaya. Vishayaton, it's a very important word. People go and report against their colleagues and all to harm them. It's vishaya. Vasha, washim. Ismul fa'il is it? Washim, not washing. Washin, plural, wushatun. Just like mashin, mushatun. Mashin, pedestrian, mushatun. Walin, wulatun. So, washin, wushatun. Another meaning of washa yeshi is to embellish a thing with different colors, to decorate a thing with different colors. It also means embroidering. Embroidery with different colors, threads with different of different colors, you make flowers and all. It is also washa yeshi. Masdar is shiyatun. Washa yeshi. Shiyatun. In the Quran, in Surah Al-Baqarah, where the Jews are asked to slaughter a cow. Musallamatun la shiyata fiha. La shiyata fiha. Musallama, it's complete. La shiyata fiha. There's no mark of a different color. It's one color. Faqi'un launuha. Safra'u. It's yellow. Faqi'un launuha. Very bright yellow. Musallamatun la shiyata fiha. There's no mark of a different color. Yes. Washa yeshi, so two meanings. One is to carry tales, the other is to decorate with different colors. So, la ta'khudhuhu sinatun wala nawm. These are qualities of the created beings. They sleep and they are drowsy. La ta'khudhuhu sinatun fa'il. هو مفعول به الله سبحانه وتعالى لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم. نوم is مصدر, also سنة is مصدر. وصن له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض. To him belongs whatever is in the heavens and the earth. له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض. Here I would like to mention an important thing. We have learned in book 3 and book 2 also, I think, book 3, the qabar can be either mufrad, muhammadun, naimun, or jumla smiya, muhammadun, abuhu, tajirun, or a verb, muhammadun, yanamu, kathiran, or shibu jumla. Muhammadun fil bayti. Al-dharf, the other one. The grammarians say that shibu jumla actually is not the khabar. There is a khabar which is mahzuf and shibu jumla is muta'alliq. What is the khabar, actual khabar? It can be either جملة فعلية استقر استقر means it settled down or جملة اسمية مستقر. So when you say الكتاب على المكتب. According to grammarians, it is الكتاب استقر على المكتب. It settled down on the table. Or it is settled down on the table. الكتاب مستقر على المكتب. Of course, nobody says this. But grammarians construct the sentence like this because in certain cases, we need this. I'll tell you why. If we say, لمن لمن الكتاب لمن الكتاب الذي على المكتب. What does it mean? Whose book is the whose is the book which is on the desk. Now, الذي is موصول نعت لي الكتاب. على المكتب is صلة الموصول. But صلة الموصول should contain what? عيد. Yesterday we spoke about this. عيد. Pronoun which goes back to الذي. Where is the على المكتب? We don't have an عيد. You follow me? That is why in such cases we need to have this istaqarra business. So we say أين الكتاب الذي استقر على المكتب. So where is the عيد? The ضمير مستتر in استقر. Where is the book which has settled down, which has occupied the desk? Then you have the عيد. That is why the grammarians say that shibh jumla, whether it is dwarf or it is jar majroor, by itself is not the khabar. There is a khabar which should be either istaqarra or mustaqirrun. Even if I say mustaqirrun, there is a dhamir there. Of course, we don't use it in writing or in speech. It is to be reconstructed in our mind for the sake of this grammatical point. لَهُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ لَهُ. To him belongs مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ. Again, you see, مَا here is موصولَ. مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ مَا اسْتَقَرَّ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ. Otherwise, you will not have عَيْد. لَهُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. Unto him belongs whatever is in the heavens and the earth. مَنْ ذَلَّذِي يَشْفَعُ عِنْدَهُ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِهِ. مَنْ ذَا. ذَا is خَبَر. مَنْ is مُبْتَدَى. Who is it? Who? مَنْ ذَا. Who is it? He. ذَا is the word you have in ha, ذَا. Where ha is harf tanbih. Harfu tanbih. But the real word, the actual word is ذَا. ذَا is the ism al-ishara. And ha is harf tanbih. A letter to draw your attention to. هذا. So من ذا, who is it? الذي is نعت لذا. الذي يشفع عنده. شفع يشفع. To intercede. To intercede. شفيع. شفيع. We also have شافعٌ اسم الفاعل and شفيعٌ صفة اسم المبالغة صيغة المبالغة. شفيعٌ شافعٌ مصدر الشفاعة. Intercession. That is to speak on somebody's behalf. You go and tell him he is a good, very good man, he can do your job. So you employ him. That's intercession. مَنْ ذَلَّذِي يَشْفَعُ عِنْدَهُ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِهِ مَنْ ذَلَّذِي. This is question, but it has the force of a negative. There is none who can intercede. As you say, it's used to say, مَنْ لَا يَفْهَمْ هَذَا مَنْ لَا عَرِفَ هَذَا. Who doesn't know this? That means there is none who doesn't know this. So مَنْ ذَا الَّذِي, who is there, who is the one who can intercede with him? إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ, except with his permission, of course. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if he permits somebody to speak on behalf of somebody else, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for example. مَنْ ذَا الَّذِي يَشْفَعُ شَفَعَ يَشْفَعُ فَعَلَى يَفْعَلُ. Shafa'atun is a masdar, and shafi'un is ism fa'il, shafi'un is ism mubalagh. Indahu, you got here this waw, small waw, because indahu is long vowel, and then there is also madda, because it is long vowel followed by a hamza, by the next word. You follow me? عِنْدَهُ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِهِ يَعْلَمُ مَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَمَا خَلْفَهُمْ يَعْلَمُ مَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ. So in Arabic, مَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِي, مَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ means in front, because between the two hands. بَيْنَ يَدَيْكِ لَا تَمُرَّ بَيْنَ يَدَيْ الْمُصَلِّ. Don't pass in front of the musalli. بَيْنَ يَدَيْ, between the two hands of, that is in front. مَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ, because it's plural, أَيْدِي. يَدُون plural, أَيْدِن. أَيْ This is ism manqus. I din with alif lam al aidi al aidi rafa'u aidiyahum, they raise their hands. Rafa'u aidiya mansub aidiyahum, rafa'u aidiyahum. Irfa'u aidiyakum, raise your hands. Irfa'u aydiyakum. So aydin, yadun, aydin. Yadani, muthanna, yadani. Ya'lamu ma bayna aydihim wa ma khalfahum. And what is behind? Ma bayna aydihim wa ma khalfahum. Now, ma khalfahum, this is also dharf. And also must have ma staqarra khalfahum. مَا اسْتَقَرَّ, and that what has settled down behind them. مَا خَلْفَهُمْ ظَرْف. وَلَا يُحِيطُونَ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنْ عِلْمِهِ إِلَّا بِمَا شَاءَ. أَحَاطَ, which verb? Fourth. أَفْعَلَ. أَحَاطَ يُحِيطُ. أَحَاطَ بِهِ. You say أَحَاطَ بِالشَّيْءِ. أَحَاطَ بِالشَّيْءِ means to encircle, to encircle, to be from all sides, to take someone from all the sides. That's the original meaning. Secondary meaning is to have a thorough knowledge, as if you know the matter thoroughly from all the four sides. La yuhituna وَلَا يُحِيطُونَ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنْ عِلْمِهِ. That is, they do not comprehend or know thoroughly anything of his knowledge. لَا يُحِيطُونَ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنْ عِلْمِهِ, they have no knowledge of, they do not know anything of His knowledge, Allah's knowledge. Illa bima sha, except that which Allah wills. When He wills, He gives part of the knowledge, and you know this, but otherwise you don't. وَلَا يُحِيطُونَ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنْ عِلْمِهِ إِلَّا بِمَا شَاءَ شَاءَ we have seen إِلَّا بِمَا شَاءَ Where is the عَائِد? مَا is مَا مَوْصُولَ شَاءَ is سِلَطُ الْمَوْصُول أَيْنَ الْعَائِد Where is the عَائِد? Who, which has been omitted, illa bima sha'a hu, except what He wills. Wasi'a kursiyuhu samawati wal ard, wala ya'uduhu hifdhuhuma, wa huwa al-aliyyu al-azim. Wasi'a yasa'u. This is bithal wawi. Wasi'a, ba'ad fa'ila yaf'alu, wasi'a. مضارع يسعوا like وضع يضع وسع يسعوا ساعة مصدر is we have seen wall is omitted. وَسِعَ يَسَعُ وَسِعَ كُرْسِيُّهُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ We say, هَذِهِ السَّيَّارَةُ تَسَعُ أَرْبَعَةَ رُكَّابٍ What does it mean? هَذِهِ السَّيَّارَةُ تَسَعُ Can accommodate أَرْبَعَةَ رُكَّابٍ Four passengers. Yes. وَسِعَ يَسَعُ هَذَا الْمَكَانِ لَا يَسَعُ This place is not enough for us. لَا يَسَعُ وَسِعَ كُرْسِيُّهُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ That is, a throne encompasses the heavens and the earth. We shall complete the next session. The time is up.
أَمَّا بَعْد
Brothers and sisters, in the previous session, we had almost finished the first ayah of the third lesson, which is Ayatul Kursi. We'll quickly go through the ayah once again before we pass on to the next ayah. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم I mentioned to you القيوم is actually on the measure of فيعول it was قيوم the vowel has been assimilated to ya it became قيوم الحي is from حي يحيى to be alive الحي is the living القيوم the sustainer لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم سنة is the مصدر with the omission of the واو from وسنة يوسن سنة is drowsiness لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض من ذا الذي يشفع عنده إلا بإذنه من ذا ذا اسم الإشارة من ذا مبتدا خبر الذي is نعت or it can also be بدل يشفع عنده إلا بإذنه يعلم ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم ولا يحيطون بشيء من علمه إلا بما شاء أحاط بالشيء to surround a thing أحاط بي والله محيط بالكافرين Allah is surrounding the unbelievers. So أحاط من علمه يحيطون بشيء من علمه to comprehend completely, know thoroughly anything. وسع كرسيه السماوات والأرض. His throne extends to the heavens and the earth. وسع يسع فعل يفعل باب سمع يسمع وسع يسع سعة مصدر سعة. So you can say, for example, كم ساعة كم أو ما ساعة أو كم ساعة هذه الغرفة كم ساعة هذه الغرفة يعني how many does this room accommodate. ساعة ساعة هذا الماعون. ماعون is a vessel. ماعون in the Quran, سورة الماعون, vessel. كم ساعة هذا الماعون, how much does this vessel accommodate, take. وسع يسع السماوات. What is the Arab of السماوات here? مجرور. It has كسرة. Is it مجرور? No, it is منصوب. اي نعم. جمع المؤنث السالم. وسع كرسيه السماوات والأرض. والأرض has got فتحة. That is the normal ending. ولا يؤوده حفظهما وهو العلي العظيم. عاد يؤود. عاد يؤود. عاد يؤود means to be a tiring thing, to make someone tired. هذا الأمر يؤودني. هذا الأمر يؤودني. هذا العمل يؤودني. This work makes me tired. To weary, or to make someone tired. عاد يؤود. What type of verb is this? This is أجوف. And there is another thing. It is محموز. همزة and واو and دال. First letter is همزة. Second radical is واو. The third radical is دال. So it is محموز and أجوف. أجوف واوي. عاد يؤود. ولا يؤود حفظهما. حفظ يحفظ. حفظ باب سمع. حفظ يحفظ مصدر is حفظ. To guard, to protect. حفظ. Of course, حفظ we have learned in the sense of to memorize. حفظت القرآن. يحفظ. فلان مثلا بلال يحفظ القرآن كله. يحفظ القرآن كله. That also means protecting the text in your heart. So the primary meaning is to protect, to guard. حفظ يحفظ. ولا يؤوده حفظهما. Where is the فاعل here? حفظ. حفظ is the فاعل. مفعول به is who, and who refers to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لا يؤوده حفظهما. That is taking care of the heavens and the earth. Does not make Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tired. It's not tiresome for him. As the ayah starts, commences with Al-Qayyum. Al-Qayyum, I told you, the one who manages the universe. So the ayah ends with a reference to this huge task, but it does not make Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tired. وَلَا يَؤُودُهُ حِفْظُهُمَا وَهُوَ الْعَلِيُّ الْعَظِيمُ. Ali is from عَلَى يَعْلُو. عَلَى يَعْلُو. عَلَى. What bab is this? Which bab is this? على يعلو نصر أنصر. على يعلو علوا. علوا. To be high, to be sublime. ala ya'lu. Ismul fa'il, alin. Because it is fi'l naqis, the ya will be omitted. Alin. We have learned in the book, bi sawtin alin. Iqra hadhihi al-ayata bi sawtin alin. The loud voice. Aliyun is ismul mubalagha. Aliyun on the pattern of Ali, fa'ilun, Ali. Sublime. Wa huwa al-aliyul azim. Azim, the great, the verb is azuma ya'zum. Which verb is this? Kathura yakthur. Azuma ya'u'u group. The past tense in the Madi, U, in the Mudari also, U. Of course, the verbs of this type are very few. Azuma, ya'zumu. Azuma. Ya'zum, izaman. عظم عظم يعظم عظيم verbs from this bab do not have اسم الفاعل and the measure of فاعل they have the measure of فعيل عظم يعظم عظيم كثر يكثر كثير نعم كرم يكم كريم وهو العلي العظيم. Let us see some of the إعراب of some of these آيات. الله لا إله إلا هو الله مبتدا and this, the sentence لا إله إلا هو this is خبر it has got a number of أخبار خبر plural أخبار. Al-Hayyu is another khabar. Allahu al-Hayyu. Al-Qayyum is another khabar. But Al-Hayyu al-Qayyum can also be na'at li Allah. Allahu al-Hayyu al-Qayyum la ilaha illahu. So it can be khabar and it can also be na'at li Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. La ta'khudhuhu sinatun wala nawm. This is another khabar. If you have la ilaha, la ilaha illa huwa, one, hay, two, qayyum, three. La ta'khudhu sinatun wala nawm, four. Lahu ma fi samawati wa ma fi al-ard, five. And then, ya'lamu ma bayna aydihim wa ma khalfahum, six. Wasi'a kursiyuhu samawati, seven. This is the famous Ayatul Kursi. Now we have seen, I told you that Mithal Wawi, usually we have done Wazana Yazinu, Ba Fa'ila Yaf'ilu, Fa'ala Yaf'ilu, Dharaba Yadribu, Wazana Yazinu, Wajada Yajidu, Wa'ada Ya'idu. But we have two examples here of Fa'ila Yaf'ilu. Wasina yawsanu. In yawsanu, waw remains. In wajada yajidu, waw is omitted. First article is omitted. But in wasina yawsanu, the waw is retained. Please remember that, mark that. And also wajila yawjalu. This is also a Quranic word. It occurs a couple of times in the Quran. Two examples of this word in the the additional notes. Yes, 38, number 3, wajila. Innama al-mu'minun al-lazina idha dhukira Allah wajilat qulubuhum. Innama al-mu'minun, innama. Only, innama al-ayatu bin-niyat. So innama is for We have learned this for Hassan. إنما المؤمنون, true believers, are only those الذين إذا ذكر الله, when Allah is mentioned, وجلت قلوبهم, their hearts feel fear. وجلت قلوبهم وإذا تليت عليهم آياته زادتهم إيمانا. And when the revelations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are read out to them, وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ تَلَا يَتْلُو, we have seen yesterday, تَلَا تُلِيَتْ, passive voice, عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ, آيَاتُ مرفوع, لماذا, why? نائب فاعل. وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا. زَادَ takes two مفعول, زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا, it increases them in knowledge. The reading of the ayat, zadathum, hum is the first mafrool, and imanan, wa ala rabbihim yatawakkalun. Zadat, al-fa'il refers to dhamir mustatir, refers to ayat. When the revelations are the, when the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala read out to them, these ayat increase them in iman, in faith. No, it takes two objects. The next line, another ayah, where we have wajila, وَنَبِّئْهُمْ عَنْ ضَيْفِ إِبْرَاهِيمِ, وَنَبِّئْهُمْ, and inform them, نَبِّئْ, amr, from which bab? نَبَّأَ, second, نَبَّأَ, you know, نَبَأٌ is news. أَنْبَأٌ, نَبَأٌ. نَبَّأَ, to inform. أَمْر, نَبِّئْهُمْ عَنْ ضَيْفِ إِبْرَاهِيمِ, inform them about the guests, Ibrahim's guests. ضَيْف is singular, but it's plural meaning. There are certain words like aduun, which are used both for singular and plural. And about the guests of Ibrahim, because what do you say plural? Because next ayah you say إِذْ دَخَلُوا عَلَيْهِ, دَخَلُوا, when they came into his house. فَقَالُوا سَلَامًا, they said salam. قَالَ إِنَّا مِنْكُمْ وَجِلُونَ. Qala, Ibrahim alayhi salam said, Qala, the Zamir refers to Ibrahim alayhi salam, inna or innana, minkum wajilun. Wajilun, this is it's a noun, wajilun. Wajilun is afraid. And it's a ism mubalagha, wajilun. Wajilun. So, on the measure of fa'ilun, wajilun, plural, wajilun. Inna minkum wajiluna. Inna minkum wajiluna. Because Ibrahim alayhi salam found that they were strange, their habits were strange. And when the food was, in another ayah, when the food was served to them, their hands did not reach there. So, inna minkum wajilun. We are afraid of you. Qalu la tawjal. This is a word that you should remember. Wajila yawjalu, tawjalu, and this is la nahiya. La tawjal, don't fear, do not be afraid. La tawjal, inna nubashiruka bi ghulamin alim. Inna nubashiruka, we give you good tidings of a boy endowed with knowledge. Bi ghulamin alim. قَالُوا لَا تَوْجَلْ. So we have seen the ماضي وَجِلَتْ, and this is مضارع لَا تَوْجَلْ. So these two words that we have learned, وَسِنَ يَوْسَنُ and وَجِلَ يَوْجَلُ, the waw is not omitted in the مضارع.